Let us now consider some more examples of unitary transformations. The first example that we'll consider is the unitary called x, which looks like that. Let's first verify that x is indeed unitary. So we have to compute x dagger x. Note that here x dagger, the conjugate transpose, is just equal to x. So x is what we call a Hermitian matrix. To check that the matrix is unitary, we thus have to compute x times x. And if you compute that, you can easily convince yourself that this gives us exactly the identity matrix. So x is unitary. It is now kind of useful to think, what does this operation actually do to an element of the standard basis? Let's compute x applied to 0. So x times 1, 0, which gives me 0, 1, which is just one of the standard basis elements. However, it is 1. Now, what happens if I apply x to 1? Remember that the unitary operation has to preserve the inner product. And 0 and 1 are orthogonal, so we should get a vector which is again orthogonal to 1. Of course, we know what that is, namely it's 0, but you can easily verify that indeed, if I do this computation, I will get 0. We thus see that x acts as a bit flip operator. It exchanges the two elements of the standard basis. It turns a 0 into a 1 and a 1 into a 0. Let's consider another example of a unitary operation, which is usually called z. Z looks like this. And the first thing that we want to do is we want to check whether the matrix is unitary. Again, observe that Z is Hermitian, so X dagger. Sorry, Z dagger is just equal to Z. So in order to check that Z is unitary, we can just compute Z times Z. And if I do that computation, we'll find that this gives us 1, 0, 0, 1, which is just the identity matrix. What is the effect of Z on the standard basis? So let's compute Z applied to 0. So what we get is the first element is 1 and the second one is 0, so we don't do anything at all. It preserves the 0 state. Let's have a look what Z does to 1. me write that out. So the first element stays zero, and the second element remains one except for this minus sign. So what we get is minus one. We see that while z kind of preserves the standard basis, it acts an extra minus out front. This minus up here. And this minus we will also call a face. So x and z are bit flip and phase flip operations, which means that we add a minus to the one state for the phase flip. We will also call these the Pauli X and Pauli Z matrices. I'm not going to make this calculation here, but it's interesting for you to see what does Z do to the plus and minus bases. Or in short, the Hadamard bases. If you do this calculation, we will find that z actually swaps the two basis elements around. So if I do this calculation, which you should be doing, z applied to plus gives me minus, and z applied to minus gives me plus. In terms of the plus minus basis, the Hadamard basis, z just acts as a bit flip operation, just like x acted as a bit flip operation for the standard basis. The last example that we'll consider is a combination of x and z. Indeed, if we apply two unitary operations consecutively, the resulting transformation will also be unitary. In fact, let's always imagine I first do a unitary U1, and then I do a unitary U2, which gives me some overall unitary U. Well, my claim is that this is unitary, so let's convince ourselves of that. So we want that U dagger U, let me write this out, it is U1 dagger, U2 dagger, U2, U1. And because this here is unitary, I get the identity. And because this here is unitary, I again get the identity. So overall, U dagger U is the identity, and you can convince yourself, in fact, that the same is true for U, U dagger. So if we combine two unitaries, we get a unitary operation. And in particular, if we combine two unitaries, where the first one is, say, z, and the second one is x, we get a unitary. And this unitary has a special name. It is often called y. Sometimes we will also put an I in front of the x times z. What effect does this new unitary, the operator y, have on the standard basis? It consists of x and z, and we already know what these individually do to the standard basis. So if I compute this, y applied to 0 z will do exactly nothing to the 0 while x flips the bit. So this will do, z will do nothing and X flips the bit around. Similarly, if I apply Y to 1, Z adds a face, and X flips the bits. So we've now seen three examples of unitary operation. If you want to learn quantum computing, you would have to investigate much more unitary operations than the operations X, Z, and Y. But for our class here, quantum cryptography, the Hadamard operation H, X, and Z are all the operations that we'll consider.